I also got a message this morning from Don Newcomb's widow, Karen, and she sent a letter that Hank had written Don Newcomb when he became when he turned 85 years old. So here's what the letter says. Mr. Verducci's going to read it.
Yeah, I believe this is from 2011 when Don turned 85. Harold, congratulations, Don, on reaching 85. But I have to admit that it's hard to believe. In my mind, you will forever be fixed as that young yet veteran pitcher who was so tough on the field and so helpful off the field. On the mound, Don Newcomb was as good as they came. You broke in at a time when black players had to be more than good enough. We had to excel to make a big league roster. You showed you could be as dominant and crafty as anybody in the game. And when it came to sheer competitiveness, I never faced anyone fiercer. But what meant the most to me was a side of you that only a few of us saw. That was how you reached out to me and other young blacks trying to establish ourselves as major leaguers. You knew how high the odds were stacked against us and how much we had to deal with. That's because you were dealing with it too. When the Dodgers and Braves would head north from spring training, we'd play exhibition games in places where segregation was still the law. And so the blacks from both teams would stay in the same hotel and eat in the same diners. For me, those times were an education like none other. You and Jack and Campy taught me how to stay focused and not get distracted. You were living, breathing role models of how to play the game and how to carry yourself as a man. To me, you three were mentors and friends who had more influence on my early career than any coach or teammate. So I'm honored to say happy birthday. And thanks to a man whose courage and friendship provided a guiding light at the most critical time of my life. And I'm sure glad that I don't have to stand in against you tonight. Happy birthday, Don, and many more. That's from 2011. Obviously, Hank writing about Jackie Robinson, Roy Campanella, and Don Newcomb being mentors. And blazing a trail, I can only imagine, and only they can really understand what it was to blaze those trails. That is a fraternity of a select few, the courageous and the truly great.
And to face the daily humiliation and the anger that would just be there on a daily basis, extremely difficult. And then to transcend that.
Well, you know, to know that you're blazing a trail for people that you may never, ever meet, you may never come across, and you're taking all the things on, to remember those who came before you. And that's Hank Aaron, you know, to go back and write that letter and just the importance. I can't imagine what that made Don Newcomb feel like, because you go through things and so often you don't know who you're opening the door for down the way. I'm sure Campy and Jackie and Newcomb had no idea that someday Hank Aaron was going to be the home run king and open those doors and be an ambassador for a country. So that's powerful. Thanks for reading that, Tom. I wasn't going to be able to get through that, so I appreciate that.
Special.